Namaskar, hello and welcome to NCRT's live phone-in program. For all the 9th class students, this maths class is for you and we are going to discuss Heron's formula. This is the first part of this topic and there will be many more parts in the future as well. So keep on watching these sessions and this will be on our PM eVidya channel number 9. So if you have any questions, any queries, please send us on our email ID, which is dth.class9@ciet.nic.in. Let's just meet our expert for this session. We have with us Ms. Usha Pillai. Welcome, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you too. So ma'am is from Campion School, Bhopal. And if you want to know the details of our schedule, our timetable, our programs, then please visit our website CIET and Swayam Prabha. You'll get all the details over there. Let's begin this entire session and ask ma'am, what is this Heron's formula? What is this entire session all about?
So we can start.
Yes, ma'am.
So good afternoon, children. Already TAMAN exam is coming nearer to you. They are already studied about real numbers, then polynomials we studied, then Heron's. Now we are studying Heron's formula, lines and angles and coordinate geometry is completed. Now we can start with the new chapter, Heron's formula. This is related to a triangle and this formula already find out by the great mathematician Heron, and we are already studied about area of a triangle. The area enclosed by this polygon with the three sides is called area of a triangle. So here we are already studied in 7th class what is the area of a triangle whose base and height is given. Here we are given base and height of a triangle. This is the base and here we are given the height. So area of a triangle is half base into this perpendicular height, that is half base into height. Now if we are given an equilateral triangle, there are three types of triangles. We are already studied about each type of triangle. If all the sides are equal, we can say it as an equilateral triangle, and if two sides of a triangle are equal, it is an isosceles triangle. And if all the three sides are different, it is called a scalene triangle. So if base and height of any triangle is given, we can find the area by half base into height. Suppose we are given an equilateral triangle whose sides are of a units. Equilateral triangle means all the three sides are equal. So the area of an equilateral triangle we can find by this formula, root 3 a square upon 4. And already we have studied, if we are given a triangle, perimeter of a triangle is sum of all the three sides. Here, perimeter of an equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal, we can say 3 into side, that is 3 into a. If we are given the length of one side of a triangle as a, perimeter of an equilateral triangle is 3 into side, that is 3a. Now the next is, we have to study about Heron's, we can learn about Heron's formula. By using Heron's formula, how to find the area of a triangle. We are given the three sides of a triangle as A, B and C. So the sides of a triangle are A, B, C. We know the perimeter of a triangle is sum of all the three sides, that is A plus B plus C. Here we have to find the semi-perimeter of a triangle, that is A plus B plus C upon 2. Half of the perimeter of a triangle is called semi-perimeter. When we are using Heron's formula, we need to use semi-perimeter in the formula. So area of a triangle by using Heron's formula is root of s into s minus a into s minus b into s minus c, where s is the semi-perimeter, a plus b plus c upon 2. Now, suppose we are given an isosceles triangle having base b and each of its equal sides is a, then the area is b into root of 4a square minus b square upon 4. We can use it for finding the area of an isosceles triangle. It is not given in our NCERT book, but we can use it. By using all these formulas, we can find the area of different types of triangular area. That is, first application we are given as, in the first question we are given, a traffic signal board indicating school ahead is an equilateral triangle with side A. Find the area of the signal board using Heron's formula if its perimeter is 180 centimeters. What will be the area of the signal board? First, we are given perimeter of an equilateral triangle. Already we have studied 3 into side, that is 3A, equal to 180 is given. So we can say A is equal to length of one side of equilateral triangle is 180 upon 3, that is 60 centimeter. All of you understood how to find the length of one side of an equilateral triangle if we are given perimeter. Now, how to find semi-perimeter? We have to find the formula for equilateral triangle, area of an equilateral triangle by Heron's formula, that is derivation of the formula we have to do first. Then we will apply the value of A in this. So first the semi-perimeter is A plus B plus C upon 2, that is all the three sides are A. So we can say A plus A upon 2, that is 3A upon 2. Here, area of an equilateral triangle equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. That is, S is given as 3A upon 2. Here it is 3A upon 2 minus A, 3 upon 2 minus A in all the three brackets because it is an equilateral triangle. If we take LCM of this, we get LCM as 2. So 2 into A is 2A will come here, that is root of 3A upon 2 into 3a minus 2a upon 2 into 3a minus 2a upon 2 into 3a minus 2a upon 2. We can find the answer as root of 3a upon 2 into a by 2 into a by 2 into a by 2. Root 3 is an irrational number, so we can write it as a. A is 4 times. When we are taking square root, we get a square. 2 is also 4 times, so square root is 2 into 2, that is 4. So the formula we got as root 3 a square upon 4, that is root 3 into 60 into 60. Already we got the length of one side of an equilateral triangle as 60 centimeters. So it is root 3 into 60 upon 4, that is when we cancel 60 by 4 and multiplying, we get 900 root 3 centimeters square. Now, in the next question, we can see there is a slide in a park is given. One of its side walls has been painted in some color with a message, keep the park green and clean. If the sides of the wall are given as 15 meter, 11 meter and 6 meter, find the area painted in color. Here in blue color, we are given this triangle and the length A, B, C are given. Length of three sides of this triangle is given as 15 meter, 11 meter, and 6 meter. So, here A is equal to 15 meter, B equal to 11 meter, C equal to 6 meter. So, the semi-perimeter S is equal to A plus B plus C upon 2. We can add these three sides. 15 plus 11 plus 6 upon 2 is 32 upon 2, that is 16 meter. Now we can apply this in Heron's formula to find this area. Area painted in color equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. That is root of 16 into 16 minus 15 into 16 minus 11 into 16 minus 6. We got root square root of 16 into 1 into 5 into 10. Here we can find 16 as 4 into 4 and 10 as 5 into 2. So 4 into 4 square root is 4 itself. 5 into 5 we are getting square root is 5. Root 2 is remaining. So 5 into 4 is 20 root 2 meter square. Now in the next question, we are given two sides of a triangle as 18 centimeter and 10 centimeter. And also we are given perimeter of a triangle as 42 centimeter. We already learned perimeter of a triangle is A plus B plus C, that is given as 42 centimeter. The A is 18 centimeter and B is 10 centimeter. How can we find C? We can find C by subtracting sum of these two sides from the perimeter, that is 42 minus 18 plus 10, that is 42 minus 28 equal to 14 centimeter. So S is equal to A plus B plus C upon 2, that is 42 upon 2 is 21 centimeter. Now we can find area of a triangle by Heron's formula, that is root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C, where S is equal to 21. So root of 21 into 21 minus 18 into 21 minus 10 into 21 minus 14. Here we got square root of 21 into 3 into 11 into 7. We can write 21 as 7 into 3 into 3 into 11 into 7. That is for 7 and 3 are given. So 1, 7 and 3 are coming out. So square root is, root of this number is 7. These are 21. And the 11 is given in the root because it is an irrational number. We can write the answer as 21 into root of 11. If we can find the root of 11 by long division method, we can find the answer in decimal also. In the MCQ part, if we are given the answer in decimals, we have to find the square root of 11 by long division method. You are already studied in 8th class. Now, the next question is, sides of a triangle are in the ratio 12 ratio 17 ratio 25 and its perimeter is given as 540 centimeters. So find its area. So let the sides be 12x, 17x and 25x. How to find this length? Perimeter is sum of all the three sides, that is 12x plus 17x plus 25x equal to 540. That is 54x is equal to 540. So we can say x is equal to 540 upon 54 is 10. Now we can find the length of each side by multiplying these ratios by 10. That is A equal to 12 into 10 is 120. B is equal to 17 into 10, 170 centimeter. C is equal to 25 into 10 is 250 centimeter. Now, how to find semi-perimeter S? Semi-perimeter S is A plus B plus C upon 2. Sum of all the sides is perimeter. When we are adding these three, 120 plus 170 plus 250, already we are given the perimeter as 540. We can directly divide 540 by 2 also. That is 270 centimeter. Now, we can find area by Heron's formula. That is root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. S is 270 centimeter. So, applying the values, root of 270 into 270 minus 120 into 270 minus 170 into 270 minus 250. What is 270 minus 120? That is 150. 270 minus 170 is 100. And 270 minus 250 is 20. So, we can make factors of these numbers. Here 270 is given, we can write it as 9 into 3 into 10, 9 threes are 27 into 10, 270. 150 is given, here it is 3 into 5 into 10. Then 100 is given, you know the square root of 100 is 10. And 20 is given as 5 into 4. So we can take the square root of all these numbers, square root of 9 is 3, and 2 threes are given, so one more 3 is coming outside, then 10 into 10 is given, then 10 or 100, square root of 100 is 10, and square root of 4 is 2. So when we are multiplying this, we get 9000 centimeter square as the area of this triangle, whose sides are in the ratio 12 ratio 17 ratio 25, and the perimeter as 540 centimeter. This is a lengthy process, but easy questions are given in Heron's formula. All of you can study very easily by understanding only semi-perimeter formula and Heron's formula. We can do so many questions by using these formulas. In the next question, we are given an isosceles triangle has perimeter 30 cm and each of its equal sides is 12 cm. Find the area of the triangle. We are given the equal sides, means in an isosceles triangle there are two equal sides. So we can take A as 12 centimeter and B is also as 12 centimeter. But we are not given C. How to find it? Perimeter method, sum of two sides becomes subset. That is 30 minus 12 plus 12. That is 30 minus 24 is 6 centimeter. So we got the third side as 6 centimeter. Now semi-pyramid is A plus B plus C. Pyramid is given as 30 upon 2 is 50. So we can apply it in this formula, Heron's formula. Area of the triangle is root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. That is 15 into 15 minus 12 into 15 minus 12 into 15 minus 6. That is 15. 15 can be written as 3 into 5. Here it is 3 and 3. 15 minus 6 is 9. So 3 is coming 2 times. So we can take 1, 3 here. And the square root of 9 is 3. So 9. Remaining part is 5 into 1, 3. That is root 15. So we can write the answer as 9 root 15 centimeter square. Now in the next question, here we are given to find the length of each side of an equilateral triangle having an area 9 root 3 centimeter square. We are already learned about the formula for finding area of an equilateral triangle as root 3 a square upon 4. We are given the area as 9 root 3. So root 3 a square upon 4 is 9 root 3. The root 3 and root 3 are cancelled. So a square equal to 4 into 9. That is 4 into 9. That is 36. So we can find the length of one side a equal to root of 36. That is 6 centimeter. We can find the length of one side of an equilateral triangle by this method, by using the formula root 3 a square upon 4. Now in the next question, we are given the base and the corresponding altitude of a parallelogram are given as 10 centimeter and 7 centimeter. Find its area. We are already learned if they are given area of a triangle and base and height is given, area of a triangle is half base into height. But here we are given a parallelogram, then the area we are already learned as base into height in 7th class. So base and altitude means height of one vertex to opposite side. That is 7 centimeter is given. So we can say the base is 10 centimeter and the height is 7 centimeter. So area of a parallelogram is base into height, that is 10 into 7, 70 centimeter square. Now in the next question, we are given the base of a right-angled triangle measures 4 cm. Here we can see BC is 4 cm. And its hypotenuse measures 5 cm. Here the longest side is hypotenuse, the side opposite to 90 degrees. Now, how can we find the area of the triangle? Here, in a right-angled triangle, base is given. We are not given height. We can use the formula half base into height. But we can find height of this triangle by using Pythagoras theorem. In a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. That is Pythagoras theorem. So we can say 5 square equal to 4 square plus AB square. So here AB square we can find out by this. And AB is equal to root of I square minus 4 square. This also you are studied in 7th class. We are revising that portion by the Pythagoras theorem here. So root of I square is 25 minus 4 square is 4 into 4 is 16. So it is root 9 equal to 3 centimeter. So area of a triangle is half base into height. That is half into base is 4 and height we got as 3. So here cancelled 4 and 2 and we got answer as 6 centimeter square. In this way, by using all the different formulas, if we are given base and height in a triangle, formula for finding the area of a triangle is half base into height. If we are given an equilateral triangle of sides A, we can find the area by root 3 a square upon 4. If we are given a triangle of sides A, B and C, we can find the area by Heron's formula, that is root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. The three cases we are already studied. Now, in the next question, we are given If the area of an equilateral triangle is given as 81√3 cm², find its perimeter. Now already we learned how to find the length of one side of an equilateral triangle if we are given the area. In this question, area of an equilateral triangle is given. The formula is √3² / 4, that is 81√3. There also √3 and √3 cancel. A² = 81 × 4. So A is equal to √81 × 4. What is the square of 81? 9 × 9 = 81, so √9. √4 = 2 × 2, that is 2 is the square root. So 9 × 2 = 18 cm². So now, how can we find the perimeter of this equilateral triangle? If we are given length of one side of an equilateral triangle, we can find the perimeter by 3 × side, that is 3a, so 3 × 18 = 54 cm². Here also we are studied how to find the perimeter of different triangles. Perimeter of a scalene triangle is sum of all the three sides is a plus b plus c. We are already found out semi perimeter also for Heron's formula. Perimeter of an equilateral triangle is 3 × side. In an isosceles triangle also we can use the formula sum of all the three sides, or if b is the equal sides and a is the base, we can the third side we can say a plus 2b or whatever the side. Now in the next question we are given isosceles triangle. Here we are given an isosceles triangle has an area 8 cm². Find the length of its hypotenuse. How to find this length of its hypotenuse? Because we are not given the sides. Let the sides of equal sides of this isosceles triangles be A units. Then we can take AB and BC as A. So area of an isosceles triangle we can take as half base into height, because it is an equilateral triangle. So base is A and height is also A. So we can say area is half into A is half A², that is equal to 8. So A² = 2 × 8, that is 16. How to find A? √16, that is 4 cm. Now, by using Pythagoras theorem, we can find this hypotenuse. Here the hypotenuse is √AB² + BC² by Pythagoras theorem. Already we learned Pythagoras theorem is the square of the hypotenuse equal to the sum of the squares of the two sides. I'm repeating this because some of you don't know how to use Pythagoras theorem. So √4² + 4² that is √16 + 16. Here 16 + 16 = 32. We can write it as √2 × 16. What is the square root of 16? 4 × 4 = 16. So √4. And √2 is same as this because it is an irrational number. Here also we can find the √2 by long division method if answer is given in decimal points. So the next question here we are given is the triangular side walls of a flyover have been used for advertisements. The sides of the walls are 122 meter, 22 meter, and 120 meter. Advertisements yield an earning of 5,000 rupees per meter square per year. A company hired one of its walls for 3 months. So how much rent did it pay? So first, here we can find the area of this triangular wall. After that, we can find the cost per 5,000 rupees per meter square per year. But it is given, a company hired one of its walls for 3 months. So we had to multiply per year, that is per month it will be this upon 12. We can get what is the yearly rent after finding out 5,000 upon 12. And if we are multiplying the area into 3, we can get the total cost. So first, then we are given a length of three sides as A = 122 meter, B = 22 meter, and C = 120 meter. So what is the semi-perimeter of this? triangular ball. That is, S is equal to A plus B plus C upon 2, that is 122 plus 22 plus 120 upon 2, that is 264 upon 2 is 132 meters. When we are finding area of a triangular ball, all the sides are different, we can use Heron's formula, that is root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So it is 132 into 132 minus 122 into 132 minus 22 into 132 minus 120. Now we can subtract these brackets. 132 minus 122 is 10. 132 minus 22 is 110. And 132 minus 120 is 12. So first, if we are multiplying and finding the square root of these numbers, it will be so lengthy. And when we are finding the square root by factorizing it, we can have the square root of this as root of 132 into 10 into 110 into 12 equal to root of 12 into 11 into 10 into 11. 110 is 11 into 10 into 12. That is, here factors of 132 as 11 into 12 into 10 into this one is 11 into 10 into 12. So here two 11s are given. You can write 111, take out and 11 for the square root. 12 pairs are given, so 12 and 10 is also in there, so we can have 10. So we can find the total area by finding the multiplication of this, that is 1320. Here the yearly rent is given as 5000 rupees per meter square. So the rent paid by company for 3 months equal to, per month is 5000 upon 12. So per month is 5000 upon 12 into 3 into this area is 1320. So it is equal to, when we are cancelling this, 12 ones are 12, there also 12 ones are, so 11 into 3 is 33, 330 is here, 5000 into 330 is this much.
Okay.
16,50,000 rupees we get.
All right. Thank you, ma'am. And because we don't have any more time, we can't solve any more problems. We'll take the questions, these solutions in the next session of the same topic, Heron's formula. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you to all the participants for watching this entire session of maths. I hope you have understood the basics of Heron's formula for now. And the more sessions will come, the more understanding you'll have. So keep on watching these sessions. We are taking a leave for now, but we are coming back after a short break with our special program webinar on ICT tool, where we are going to discuss artificial intelligence for education, and that will be the fifth day of our online training on the same. Thank you so much. Namaskar.